Good evening, everyone. Tina Spaulding, Trance Channel, here today for our evening session of day 18 of 40 days and 40 nights with Jesus. Let's see what he has to say to us this evening. You are blessed beings indeed. I am that one that you know as Jesus. And at the end of each day, there is an opportunity for you to gather your thoughts together, gather your feelings together, and to sit with what has happened during the day. Each of these morning sessions is giving you something to think about, something to explore, something to question, something to come to understand more deeply. But it is very important at the end of the day for you to reflect back upon what you were able or not able to accomplish regarding the suggestions that we make in the morning. The reason this is a good idea is because there is an energy within all of you, we call it the ego mind, which is counter and believes in things opposite to what we are teaching. And for most of you, the truth is you are ruled by your egos. Your egos believe in separation. They believe that you will die. The ego believes that you are a body, that you have secret thoughts, that when you say something nasty about somebody else, you don't get hurt. There are many, many beliefs that are foundational in the ego's thought system. And you are all in that thought system because you have been born into separation. Your individual body demonstrates your belief in separation, and your society has intensively cultivated the belief in separation, individuality, and isolation. So the way your homes are built, the way your families are constructed, the things you're encouraged to do, all perpetuate separation and isolation and judgment, which causes you to move away from love and causes suffering. And yet it is the sea you swim in. It is the only thing you know. As we are bringing forth this information to you, we want you to understand that when you look at the world and you see the suffering there, you see the control mechanisms, you see the wars, you see the lack, you see the struggle that even you go through trying to support your family and make a decent life for yourself. It's a very, very challenging environment, this world of separation. And yet you are innately loving beings. This is why this world causes you so much suffering, because being separated from love is excruciatingly painful for the loving beings that you are. And yet there is this side of you that relishes in attack, that enjoys judgment, that wants to isolate. So what you have are two separate, completely separate thought systems adjacent to each other, and you are in the middle. Anytime you have a hateful or negative thought, you will slide into the ego's thought system where more ideas like that will come. Every time you have a loving thought, a forgiving thought, a kind thought, a contented thought, an easygoing thought, you go over into the Holy Spirit's thought system, which is a loving thought system, and more thoughts like that will come. So you are literally tuning into, we could liken it to a radio station. You are tuning into the hateful, negative station, or you are tuning into the loving station. And this happens with every thought you believe and act upon. So we want you to understand the power of each thought and the power of your minds as they are being manipulated by television, movies, and mainstream media systems. Every time you tune into a newscast that is showing you rioting and burning and negative stories, the ego gets stronger. That means isolation and separation get stronger, and the fight or flight or freeze response gets stronger in you. Every time you turn off your TV and go out into the garden and plant something, or get your art supplies out and do some creative project that's arising from within you, creativity arises from within your spirit, you are going to step into the Holy Spirit's thought system, which is one of communion, union, healing, health, abundance. So tonight, we would like you to reflect back upon your day. And we would like you to ask yourself, which thought system am I predominantly in, or was I predominantly in today? Was I in a space of relaxation, happiness, communion, community, communication, calmness, love, peace, joy, creativity? Or was I predominantly in a state of fear, judgment, separation, anxiety, confusion, unhappiness, disillusionment? As you reflect back on your day, we do not want you to judge what you did, but what we want you to do is, as you go to sleep tonight, we want you to say, tomorrow is going to be a better day. Tomorrow, I am going to choose peace and love and creativity more often than I did today. That is what awakening looks like. You use your free will to choose love and forgiveness more and more and more, to choose acceptance more and more and more, which seems counter to what you have been trained to do. Accepting things as they are, surely we don't want things as they are. You can accept things as they are because they've come into manifestation. They're already made. They're already in existence. And you can pivot from that point and say, I accept that there is chaos happening right now, or there are these unfair restrictions happening in my life right now, but I am not going to get mad at them because they are already in being. I am going to say, there it is. I don't want it in my future. How can I today choose more freedom-seeking thoughts, more calm, loving thoughts? This is how you're going to change the world. One thought at a time, one person at a time. We want to remind you to share these videos. Face your fears of persecution or repercussions from friends and family. Post these videos. Everybody needs to hear this information now. You are being bombarded with negative and separation-focused information. We need to see sharing this information not only as an act of courage for some of you, but as an act of love and kindness, so that someone somewhere might hear some information that they have never heard before, and it may be the turning point for them in their life. So love your brothers and sisters, share this information, and know that it is going to change many, many hearts and minds, and we are grateful for your courage and sharing of this material. I am that one that you know as Jesus, and I will speak to you again tomorrow. Thank you, everyone, for joining me this evening. I'd just like to remind you to check out our Channeling Jesus community. We have a lot of people on there who are tired of the negative and warmongering and separation-focused information. There's a lot of wonderful conversations going on there, sharing of channeling material, healing modalities, creativity. It is a very, very sweet space. If you are feeling bruised and battered by the social media mainstream products, and I'll see you again tomorrow morning. Bye.